Talk of a barrier along the border of the United States and Mexico is not new. In fact, the mayor of Nogales, Mexico actually ordered the construction of a border fence between his city and Nogales, Arizona in 1918 as a means of regulating commerce. But it was not until the 1990s that the U.S. government built the first 14 miles of what is now a matter of great debate, the border wall. The border wall, or fence, is not a controversial issue. In fact, it's a common sense idea. Ask yourself, why do we lock our doors at night? Among other things, to prevent uninvited guests from simply walking into our homes. We don't know if a threat is at the door or an unexpected visit from a relative. Either way, we want to be able to decide who comes in or who stays out. Why should our approach to securing our borders be any different? Just like any household, the United States has a welcome mat out front, with the expectation that people won't sneak in through the back door. As with other nations, being able to govern our borders is central to maintaining our national sovereignty. Every nation has an obligation to protect its people and a right to secure its borders. Since we have two land borders, why focus on the southern one? It's simple. You plug the bigger hole in the dam. Historically, more than 90% of border apprehensions occur along the U.S.-Mexico border. In fiscal year 2019, the Border Patrol apprehended 860,000 illegal aliens nationwide, but 852,000 of them were caught while attempting to cross the southwestern border. That's 99%. We also know that every year, illegal border crossings spike during warmer months. We know what is coming, yet Congress does nothing to prevent the rush to the border. The southern border also happens to be the main entry point for drug smugglers. For example, 90% of all heroin comes from south of the border. And it was along the southern border that the Border Patrol made its largest seizure of fentanyl, the dangerous opioid destroying American towns and communities. As CBP Deputy Commissioner Robert Perez warned, the volume of drugs seized is a sober reminder that we are in the midst of a national security crisis on the southwest border. A porous border not only makes it easier for violent drug cartels and gangs, such as MS-13, to smuggle weapons into the country, but adults and children as well. An open border is an incentive for migrants to put themselves and their children in danger to get here. Without a border barrier, people will gamble with their lives on a journey during which more than 30% of women are sexually assaulted and 70% of migrants experience some form of violence. The simple truth is that walls work. Michael Rubin of the American Enterprise Institute notes that border walls and fences are standard practice in other parts of the world, including India, Hungary, Greece, and Spain. In the United States, Border Patrol officials have stated that the wall in the San Diego sector has helped reduce border apprehensions. According to USA Today, illegal migrants and drug traffickers avoid sections of the border with walls or fences, which means they have to make their way through ports of entry, in turn, increasing the likelihood of detection. That is why Border Patrol officers, such as Tucson Sector Chief Patrol Agent Roy Villarreal, emphasize the effectiveness of such a barrier and call for the wall to be extended.
Well, and again, after 30 years of working in border enforcement, I can attest to the fact that walls, border fences do work. As soon as we put in infrastructure and fencing, you add technology and agents, it has a dramatic impact on that flow of illicit migrants, illicit narcotics, and it brings control to the border.
However, to be fully effective, the wall must span the U.S.-Mexico border. Opponents of the border wall claim the costs outweigh the benefits. But is that really the case? Construction cost estimates are usually within $20 to $25 billion, although some higher estimates reach $70 billion. Yet the government spends nearly twice that on illegal immigration every year. FAIR calculates the annual cost burden of illegal immigration has risen to $132 billion. And it could further increase to $200 billion by 2025. If you think about it, the border wall is a great return on our investment because it actually saves the U.S. taxpayer money in the long run. Building a border barrier would benefit the United States by securing national sovereignty, increasing national security, reducing illegal immigration, enabling drug enforcement, and saving taxpayers money. That is why we need a border wall. For more information on the costs and consequences of U.S. immigration policy, please visit www.fairus.org.